All these years, I have been humbled by the honor to lead you ever, ever onwards. From this day till the end of days.
Hi, I'm Greg Tito, and this is the video supplement to our review of Killzone 3. As far as campy action shooters go, Killzone 3 is pretty darn good. The guys from Guerrilla Games have assembled a campaign jam-packed with gorgeous set pieces and well-paced action. On top of that, the multiplayer concentrates on random objectives on a wide variety of maps that offer plenty of replay value. If you have a PS3, you should definitely get this game, but be warned, it's not a perfect specimen.
Either they die, or you do.
I enjoyed the story of Killzone 3 the same way that I enjoyed James Cameron's Avatar. It doesn't push any new emotional buttons, but it is compelling enough to keep me happy while playing. And while the strong Nazi imagery of the Hellgas puts them firmly in the villain category, they get their fair share of screen time. The power vacuum created by the death of the Emperor has Malcolm McDowell, Chairman Stahl, vying for control of the Hellgas Nation, but despite kicking ass in Clockwork Orange, McDowell only offers a lackluster performance in Killzone 3.
The Senate will beg me to forgive them.
The dialogue vacillates between fresh and even funny to ham-fisted and awkward. The plot picks up right on the heels of Killzone 2, with Sergeant Rico Velasquez having murdered the Hellgast Emperor just after he nuked his own city. Captain Narville dresses down Velasquez and Sevchenko for insubordination, a theme that gets a little old the fifth or sixth time you hear, "Are you too stupid to follow orders, Sergeant?" Still, the heroes are entertaining in their own macho way.
Forget it. I want to shoot him too.
But you didn't.
No, but that's because I'm not a jackass.
The graphics, the cinematography is just breathtaking. The vistas you explore are varied and all exquisitely rendered, from the smoking ruins of the nuked city in the opening to the icy mountains and swelling waves of the second act. Not only does the scenery look great, but the character models, vehicles, mechs, spaceships, they're all top-notch. The little touches are wonderful. One of the buildings you run through in the Hellgast City is a natural museum with its displays all smashed up. 6 months later, the city is overgrown with those same plants, and the big creeping insects have more than a little bite to them. And finally, in the third act, those cute little buggers seem to have been genetically engineered to have a big bright ass that, well, let's just say it explodes in your face when you get too close. As a shooter, Killzone tries to pack in every kind of gameplay element that it can. Stealth kills from behind, frequent helicopter levels of on-rail shooting, sniper levels, jetpacks, and cover mechanics. The cover mechanic is a bit of a misnomer, I guess, because you can and will be shot dead even if you think you're ducking behind some rubble, which is probably realistic, yeah, but also terribly frustrating. I feel like Killzone should have picked one aspect of gameplay and made it awesome, rather than present us with the smorgasbord. The good news is that the buffet of game elements is still pretty tasty. The multiplayer is dashing good fun, with classes that feel distinct and objectives that keep the match moving forward. Killzone 3 is a complete package. A solidly fun, story-driven campaign with a good script and above-average voice acting coupled with a full spectrum of shooter mechanics. I applaud Guerrilla Games for milking all of the graphics processing power they could out of the PS3 to deliver a really, really beautiful game. But I just wish they had that same laser-like focus on the gameplay to offer one or two amazingly fun features to push the game into excellence instead of an amalgam of adequacy.
Fire back! At what? Everything!